Hello everyone, in this video we're gonna turn this sunny summer day into a beautiful snowy winter day using shader graph, VFX graph, and custom passes in HDRp. And before we begin, I should mention that Brackeys did this video first, so I should give him credit. And let's begin. So the first thing we want to do is change the sun angle. So as you can see, it's pretty straight from above right now, but during winter the sun doesn't rise much higher above the horizon, so we're gonna keep it pretty low here, somewhere like there. And we're also going to change its temperature to be cooler, and also we're going to decrease its intensity. And here in my sky and fog volume, I'm going to duplicate the profile, and we can rename it to snowy or something. And here I'm going to change my clouds preset to be overcast, and that makes it look something like that. If you're using an HDRi sky, you can just change your HDRi to a snowy one. And you can tweak these lighting settings a little bit to make it look like you want it to. Alright, now let's create a snow shader. So let's create a shader graph, HDRp lit shader graph, and we can call it snow. And in here we're going to get the normal direction, the normal vector, and we're going to get the dot product of it with the direction of our snow. So we want it to be from above, and that gives us this, which we can use to mask out our snow on the object. So we also want to clamp that, so let's clamp it, create a snow material. So you can use a texture, or you can just use a noise texture. So we're gonna get a simple noise, and we can decrease it to make it bigger, and we can remap its values so that instead of going from black to white, it goes from like gray to white. And then we can multiply these, so we multiply it, and that kind of masks this texture. And we can make this a property, so we can have a vector 3, plug it into there, and we can convert this into a property. We can call it direction, and its default value would be from above. And then we can plug this into the alpha and into the diffuse, so that we see the white snow on the color, and to use the black to get rid of the parts that are not snowy, so they're transparent. And also we want it to be sampled with the world space and not the UV of each individual object. So we're gonna add a position is going to be the absolute world position, and to get the we want the Y. So this is the Y, and to get the Y direction, we want to use the the red and the blue. So here we're going to split this, and then we're going to combine the red and the blue, and that gives us the direction from above. And then we're going to use that instead of the UV for our snow texture. So whether you use a texture or a noise, you want to use this instead of the UV of the objects. And also we can expose this to control its scale. So we're going to create a float. We're going to plug it in there, and then we can convert this into a property. Let's call it scale, and let's give its default value something like 50. Alright, so with our shader selected, let's create a material, and we can call this snow material. And then we want to change the surface type to transparent. And you can change the blending mode to whichever you prefer. I think the pre-multiply looks good. Alright, so to actually put this snow on every object in the scene, we're going to create an custom pass volume, which we can call snow pass. And here we're going to add a draw renderers custom pass. And in the overrides, we give it this material. And ta-da, now we have snow on everything. So as you can see, we only have the snow on top of every object. So as you can see, we only have it on the roof of the house and also the car, and we can change its scale from this material, so we can change that, and we can change the color and everything in the shader, of course. And to exclude some objects from snow, we can put them in different layers. So for example, I don't want the street to be covered in snow. I can add a layer called not in snow, and I can put the street to be not in snow, and as you can see, it's no more snowy, but I actually like it to be snowy, so I'm gonna undo that. So there's a lot you can do with your snow shader. You can make it shiny and sparkly. There's a good video by Ben Clowert. Sorry if I butchered your last name, but that's a good video. I'll link to that in the description. He'll show you how to make sparkly snow using shader graph. Alright, that's it for our shader. Now let's create a visual effects graph. Alright, so let's drag and drop it into our scene. Alright, so here in our bounds, we're going to set the size to be really big so that our snow doesn't get killed when the camera is not looking towards this game object. So let's set it to like 100 by 100, and the capacity for this system, let's set it to something like that. And the particles that we spawn, let's increase that rate to something like 200. And for our velocity, we are going to get rid of this set velocity random, and instead in the update, we're going to add gravity to it. But because they're snow particles and they shouldn't fall so fast, we're going to decrease it to, or should I say increase it to something like 3.5, something like that. And in the initialize context, let's set shape, set position from an AA box shape. And then we're going to move this box to be like 50 meters higher, so it's there. And as you can see, the particles die before reaching the ground, so I'm going to set the lifetime to be something like 7 and 9. And now let's set the size to be, I don't know, like 60 by 60, so that we have snow coming from everywhere. And now they're falling so steadily, so let's add a little bit of turbulence to them in the update context. So alright, so as you can see, they have too much drag that takes them so long to reach the ground, so we're going to give them more lifetime. So let's make it 14 to like 20 seconds, and now they have more time to reach the ground. And we can also make it make the spawning position to be closer to the ground. So yeah, and we can change the intensity here to like 2, and that makes them move even more. And as you can see, we have this beautiful particle system now, and all we have to do is change the shape of it. So here in the output context, we can change the texture. So we can, if you have good snow textures, that's great, but I'm going to use this dust texture that comes with Unity. And for that, we're going to change the UV mode to flipbook, and it's a 2x2 flipbook. We're going to set random, set index random. So we're gonna randomly select one of those four textures, so the index goes from 0 to 3. And if you notice, the particles are now a lot smaller because of the texture. So let's add a multiply size, and we can multiply it, make it much bigger. And they really look like dust, so I really advise you use a good snow texture for it. But for now, I'm just gonna keep using this dust texture. And we don't really need a set color over lifetime, so we can get rid of it. Alright, so now we have a performance, simple, unlit particle. But if you want it to be more realistic, you can have a lit quad output. So this output supports translucency, so that your snow particles will be lit by different lightings. Alright, so now we can add some properties to this. We can add a vector 3 for wind. And then here in the update context, we can add force and plug this wind as the force. So here, as you can see, the snow is falling down, but if I change the wind, you can see that they will start going in the direction of the wind. And we can add properties for the emission and the size of our snow. So we can have an int for particle count, which we can plug into our spawn rate. And we can have a vector 3 or a vector 2 for the size of our snow area, which then we can plug into our AA box size. So here, as you can see, we can plug the x into the x and the y into the z. Alright, so this could be a starting point for you if you want to make snow for your scenes. And using custom passes, it's easy so that every object in your scene gets affected by this shader. As you can see, if I add a new object here, this object is already affected by the snow. Alright, that's it. I'll see you in another video. Peace out.